15, gives up baby for adoption. 35 years later, she receives this letter from a stranger.
Welcome to Viral Stories. Secrets, facts, and strange stories from around the world. If you find yourself amazed at what some of our fellow humans and animals can do, this is the place for you. This is a channel you're going to want to tell your friends about. Be sure to subscribe and hit that bell icon to be notified of our new uploads. Now sit back, relax, and enjoy Viral Stories.
Marathon racers say that when you get on the track, you're always prepared for the worst. Anything can happen once you tie those shoes onto your feet. Marathons are really exhausting and require a lot of willpower, and injuries are simply one of these things that accompany it. However, when she was ready to run the marathon, a Philadelphian mother had no idea what she would be in for. It wasn't due to any injuries, however. This time, it was for an injury of her heart that was just waiting to finally be healed. It was one of those days that simply turn your life around for the better. Get some tissues ready, because you could cry after this incredible story. Stacey Faix is a super mother and maybe in her 50s, though it didn't stop her from competing in the half marathon in Pittsburgh. She's been an avid runner for several years now. It's just one of those things that have been with her as long as she can remember. And she always used running as a way of decompressing. What followed on this particular day are unforgettable events. After all, she didn't know how memorable this day would be. The lady is the happy mother of two daughters and an active member of a war veteran organization, Red, White, and Blue. She has fully supported the United States Army for years now and does whatever good she can helping the veterans once their contracts expire. She knew nothing about the fact that she was about to meet a very special organization's member, a veteran that she knew but has not seen in a very long time. That was the day her life changed completely. This photo was taken seconds after a secret letter was handed over to the mother from Philadelphia. The letter was passed on to her from a friend of hers, and she had no idea what it was. On top of that, the woman didn't know what the note had written on it or who had written it. It was a quick mystery for her, and one that she was about to resolve just by reading it. She didn't know that the note was in fact from her own son, a son she hasn't seen in 35 years. She had her first child when she was 15 years old, the son that she chose to give up for adoption. She knew full well that she couldn't raise a child when she was that young. It was undoubtedly a very hard decision to make, and one that not a single mother out there wants to live through. But she knew that it was in the best interest of the baby for it to grow up in a healthy environment. She'd been searching for her son for decades, hoping that she would be reunited with him. Then the letter is read and it slowly dawns on her. Stacey begins to read the strange thing in her hands and can't believe what she sees. The note contained a message talking about someone looking for her for decades, and she knew it in her heart. She couldn't believe it. It could not be happening to her. It felt like she was in a movie, but it was actually all too real. Keep listening, because your spine will be shaking with the next photos. There was her baby boy, ready after all these years to embrace her. He'd been hiding in the crowd and waiting for the green light. He had to wait out for her to read the letter first. After she bore her son, the paperwork was lost in a flood, and there was a very slim chance for them to meet again. It was an unfortunate turn of events, especially for a mother who wanted to meet with her baby boy sometime in the future. But she learned in 2017 about the new law allowing adopters to request a birth certificate. Stephen got his biological parents' names and received the birth certificate with assistance from the authorities. He went the extra mile in search of his own mother. We now live in a new age, and in the age of social media, so his first thoughts after learning her name were to check if she's present on any of them. Afterwards, on Facebook, he found his mom and decided to send her what might have seemed like a stupid message. "Hey, I have a really weird question. Did you put a baby boy up for adoption in 1982? It didn't end there. Stephen told her he believes that he's her son. He only managed to get the name from the birth certificate, and there were many others with a name just like hers out there, so it might have seemed like a long shot at first. She replied that it was her. She was ecstatic that her son not only managed to find her, but that he decided that he would reach out to her as well. Both kept on talking online, and Stephen found his mother would be participating in the marathon, so he felt it was the perfect chance to meet her. The woman sees him and goes to embrace him without giving it a second thought. As you can see from the photo, Stacey can't believe what's going on. She picks up her son so fast that he can no longer breathe. It was the first time since she'd put him up for adoption that she could finally embrace him again. All those years of tears and sadness were replaced with tears of happiness. Accept that or not, Stephen is also an RWB Group, Branch of Ohio member. The next image may be responsible for tears running down your face. The two of them don't speak a single word and only embrace. They both waited a long time for this moment and they enjoy it. All words were meaningless at this point. There was nothing that could have been said that would have made the whole experience any better. Silence speaks, and this was just a nice proof of that. Meanwhile, the meeting was being filmed by a local media crew who arrived at the scene, and it was already being filmed by the association as well. Stephen knew he was adopted from a young age, but didn't learn Stacey's full name from his adoptive family. They unfortunately had no idea who his actual mother was. It wasn't that they didn't want to help him out, but it was just due to the fact that the adoption was done in full confidentiality, and no personal information of the mother was shared with the adoptive family. Fortunately, though it took him 35 years, he managed to finally find her. Stacey starts to cry, thinking about how much she hunted for him. Of course, he was not the only one who was searching for her, but her search ended abruptly with the loss of the documents, and she thought that it would be nearly impossible to actually find him after that. Finally, Faith took them together, and this is what happens. Stephen said in an interview with Inner Edition, "We must have hugged about 10 different times." Those two had a tough time because Stephen and Stacey avoided hugging over and over again. They were still holding each other's hands, and Stephen said that it just felt really surreal that it was finally happening because it happened so fast. It was just one of those moments where you want to hold the person forever. And at the same time, you know you can't because you need to share some words as well. What's next is more wonderful than you've ever seen before. The two decided to carry on the marathon together for about an hour after speaking for the first time in 35 years. They could have just left and gone for lunch, but they both decided that they would run the marathon as they'd signed up for it. But this time they wouldn't do it alone. They'd do it in the company of each other. For Stephen, this is a dream come true because he loves to run and his mother shares the same passion. Stacey was still in shock following the marathon. All those miles and all the exhaustion didn't shake her up one bit. After such a long time, she couldn't believe that Stephen succeeded in finding her. Both had plenty to talk about, and now they finally had time and knew each other. Running the marathon was a piece of cake in comparison to the heartbeat that both of them were experiencing prior and after the fact. Their hearts were racing, and for a good reason. Although Stephen has never stopped loving his real mom, he didn't know her real name. He was not the one to judge how or why she'd put him up for adoption. He was mature enough to understand that she was only looking out for his best interest instead of forcing him to live in a dysfunctional family with a young mother who had yet to start her own life and stand on her own two feet. Both are glad to be together, and Stacey thinks she's fortunate that Stephen has come back to her. Stephen wrote this letter to his mother. It reads, "It has been 13,075 days since you last saw me. I did not want to make you wait for one more." It can be clearly seen that he counted the few days before meeting his biological mother. It must have been one hell of a wait for him, especially. She had no idea she would be meeting him while he had all the planning to do, and not to mention all the anxiety that accompanied it all. If that's not love, then we don't know what love is. As I mentioned earlier, both of them met during the Philadelphia Marathon. Stacey has been a runner for years now, and her son is one too. But he wasn't always a runner himself. He actually had a different job prior to this great hobby. It's cool that the marathon is open to veterans, and Stephen is one too. Stacey was encouraged to find out that her son was formerly in the Air Force, and he's an American veteran. She'd been supporting the Army and the veterans for the majority of her life, and knowing that her son was one too simply filled her with delight. She would never have expected that her own son was one of the true American heroes out there. Although his mother, Stacey, was not there to guide him, he took the right path in life and made a name for himself. One of the coolest things to see in Stephen and Stacy's meeting is to know that they both share the same enthusiasm. Running marathons is not an easy task to compete, and anyone who's tried running one will gladly tell you that they're not mistaken. We think that it's safe to assume that Stephen gets his mother's love for marathons. It was simply in his DNA from the time he was born.